Hi, I'm Leslie Huffman, apple specialist with the Ontario government. In this video on high-density apple orchards, I'll show you how to train the tall spindle tree from year two to full production.
After the first year, tall spindle apple trees should be reaching for the top wire with a tall, straight leader. Each feather should have fruit spurs with burst shoots, and each terminal should have 6 to 8 inches of growth. Each tree should be secured to the trellis or support stake at several points. The area under the tree should be weed-free with adequate moisture, either with mulch or trickle lines. Starting in year two, our training goals are to maintain the dominance of the leader, encourage more spurs, and fill the fruiting zone. Maintain the leader by removing or redirecting all competing growth. Each year, secure the leader along its length. A training stake will work well until it grows above the top wire. After that, let it fall over or prune to a weaker side shoot. Look for branches that compete with the leader. Remove them with a stub cut or pinch them back, depending on their vigor. In early summer, remove vigorous shoots that emerge near the leader. Next, concentrate on the fruiting area, which needs to be filled with spurs and exposed to sunlight. Keep pruning to a minimum to encourage early cropping. Follow the 50% rule. Remove feathers or branches that are larger than 50% the diameter of the leader. This cut is best on dormant trees, using a stub cut to encourage renewal at this point. Simplify each lateral branch by removing forks. Some people describe this as cingulating or columnarizing each branch. Feathers or branches that grow above the horizontal should be tied down. Vigorous shoots may need to be positioned below the horizontal or removed entirely. Upright shoots can be tucked under branches or wire to encourage fruit buds. Keep pruning to a minimum. Remove low branches that will interfere with weed sprayers or mowing. The lowest branch should be above the knee. Remove root suckers or shoots on the trunk when present to prevent fire blight infections. And finally, remove any dead, broken, or diseased branches as general maintenance. If the leader is damaged, if fertility is too high or the rootstock is too vigorous, the tree responds with excessive regrowth called suckers or water sprouts. In this case, the balance of the tree needs to be restored. Choose a replacement leader from the strongest upright branch, tie it to the trellis or stake, and remove competing branches. Remove only the largest suckers, leaving a renewal stub. Keep pruning to a minimum by tying down or tucking branches. A properly trained tree needs to be encouraged to maximize growth and set fruit spurs. Water or irrigate every week to maximize growth. If irrigation is not available, mulching under the trees will also preserve soil moisture. Apply fertilizer or compost before bud break to maximize growth. Foliar fertilizer in season can also be used if needed. Control weeds under the trees from bud break to terminal bud set with herbicides, mulch, or cultivation. Scout weekly for insects and diseases and discourage deer and rodents. Avoid overcropping by using the Aquilafruit disc and the Cornell Young Tree Ruler to measure the diameter of the trunk or branch and indicate how many fruit to leave. Hand thin fruit as needed. Only strong branches should be permitted to crop. Training your trees is critical to achieve the high yields and quality needed in tall spindle, high density orchards. Plan your workload to get each task done on a timely basis. Your success depends on it.